This is a princess court dress, which is a ready-made suit, and I am going to show you hopefully how to go about making one of these dresses. This particular one, as I've said, is a ready-made one. This is just to give you some explanations on how to go about cutting something like this. Now, if you look at the basic shape of a princess cut dress, the way it's normally cut is very fitted on the waist, wider as it goes, almost like an umbrella shape at the bottom. And the main part of a feature of this dress is that a slight bit of excess has been taken away on the waistline to give a more defined fitted look. And then a small piece, you know, sometimes where you get a gathering on the shoulder, this is on a princess cut, you don't get that because the excess has been taken away when cutting the piece out for the side kaniya. It's almost similar to a dress, a kurta type, where the kaniya eye are actually go straight along to the top of the shoulder. This type of cut is mostly used on jilbabs and abayas because it gives a more fitted look. It's generally used on courts in the English market, ready-made market. Now, the other part of one of the things I must mention on this dress is takes me back to a very long time when I first. I need you to get down. Okay, don't come on the table. This takes me back to many years ago when I first started sewing, and this was a very big rave at the time. And I made several of these dresses at the time. Now, it's been quite a while since the fashion for these dresses went out, and we sort of sidetracked and didn't actually sew any of these. There was many variations of this dress that I had actually stitched at a very young age. Now, this particular one has the two centerpieces, which is like an open shirt type, and it's been piped along the center. It's used a contrasting colored fabric, and then also on the hemline, additional silk fabric has been used to trim this off. Generally, this type of clothing is very fitted and gives a very fitted look. You need to be nice and slim to carry something like this off. Not every person can carry this style off. It is generally for the young and the trendy type of person. I mean, I remember sewing this for my younger sisters many years ago. And she was absolutely, one of my sisters was absolutely addicted to wearing these, and she would not wear a straight kameez. Now, I have a teenage daughter who is the opposite, and who would only wear a straight kameez, who would suit something like this, but she would not actually wear anything like this. So, the fabric that I'm going to use to actually explain making this on is going to be a cotton fabric. This is on a khadar grandi. I'm not going to use anything like this. It's actually, to be honest, this is almost like a curtain fabric, but the effect, obviously, when fashion comes in, and you know, you do actually get all types of wear, and you know what, as long as it stands nicely, you can carry it off. Now, the feature of, obviously, the feature of this dress, it's a ready-made outfit, and the feature on this dress is the heavy embroidery on the back of the dress. Now, we're not going to be doing the embroidery, obviously, we're just going to be showing you the style of how to stitch something like this. If you wanted to be extravagant, there's lots of laces and trimmings available that you can actually do a feature like this on the back. If you have the time, you can also experiment and even attempt to do the embroidery, although I think a lot of the younger generation doesn't have the patience to do anything like this. The neckline on this particular outfit is a putti type of a neckline. It's been piped over in the purple trimming that's been used on the same as the bottom of the hemline. This has also been trimmed off with a double coloured silk ribbon. Now, obviously, we're not going to get exactly the same result as this, because this has been embroidered, and this has been obviously manufactured in, probably most likely, India. It's this is actually by Breeza, believe it or not. So, you know, it's a nice, beautiful ready-made suit. But the purpose over here is to actually teach you to make a dress that looks similar, and a result that we're going to get of our own. Nothing to do with trying to replicate this. All I'm showing you is an example of what you can achieve with even a lesser fabric. And if you are lucky enough to find any fabric like this, then you know what, it's not anything that's extremely hard to do. It's quite simple. Now, the pants with this are straight cut trouser pants, which I've already done the tutorials on. Our garment, the garment that we're going to make, is also in cotton. It's a cotton which is on a very, very small minute print, and I want to do this with white pants for summer. So I'm going to show you how to cut this dress on this fabric.